In a house, I'm looking for a kitchen that is good for entertaining. I have a chocolate lab, her name is Daisy. She has been with me for 9 years. In my home, I'm looking to have a space specifically for her. She can hang out there during the day while I'm going to work.
What am I, like 2 minutes from here, maybe?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, we're turning here.
My all-in budget, I would like to stay under $200,000.
All right, right here. This is the Holston house.
Oh, the house is really cute. It looks a little small from the front, though.
It's a petite house.
Well, I'll tell you how big it is. It's 3 bedrooms, 2 baths. It's 2,000 square feet, built in 1958 for Shorty and Jerry Holston, and it's listed for $115,000.
That's a good size for your first home.
Three.
I mean, it's just you and Daisy.
Yeah, it is just me and Daisy. But I like to have people over, so 3 bedrooms is plenty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have one question.
Yeah.
What is that?
That used to be a waterfall.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
In my world, it goes away.
Okay.
I like your world.
Okay.
Yeah.
Would you like to see more of my world?
I would.
Cute.
Cute.
Love the door.
So we would just recommend changing out the front door so you have a little natural light in the entry.
Yeah.
These hydrangeas on the left are so healthy, though, that I just would never want to touch those.
Yeah, I wouldn't want you to.
Once you get some
those,
hydrangeas that are really thriving in a spot, you want to leave those.
Those are beautiful. I absolutely love hydrangeas, too.
We're at about $10,000 on the exterior.
How big's the yard?
It goes all the way to the trees in the back and then about halfway between these two houses here.
Oh, that's perfect for Daisy.
Yeah, that is perfect.
But we need to talk about the inside since that is where we would spend most of your budget.
Okay.
Let's go look at it. All right.
Well, this house has a little formal living room.
It does.
In the front.
I love these floors.
Yep. Yeah.
They look original.
This wall is, I guess, like paneling?
This would have been, you know, an unpainted knotty pine finish. And then somebody at some point has painted it and then did an antique finish on it.
Which was very popular in the early 2000s. It would serve you best if we just painted the walls, changed out the light for a more modern country vibe. The oak floors are not throughout the house. It's in this front room, but it changes everywhere else.
You want to see what's in the rest?
Yeah, I kind of want to see what's in the rest.
Let's go look at it. Check out this huge kitchen.
It's a pretty classic 60s layout.
This obstructs the view for sure.
It was the thing in the 60s when they built houses. Let's build cabinets that will block your view of the room. This is the kitchen the house has. And I think to make it bigger, if we lost this door in this corner here, since there's already access to that hall from the formal living room, and then you would have your oven where it is now, but the cabinetry would continue around that corner and wrap this wall. You would delete this little peninsula, delete the hang down. If we shifted this cased opening that direction, and it was all a big open bar where you can sit on the den side.
So it would be like open into the living space more.
Yes.
Okay, I like that.
Ben is basically standing where the end of the kitchen would be. He is kind of right where the refrigerator would be built in and a microwave and a whole wall of cabinetry here. But on the back side of this wall, what is currently a little bitty dining room could become one big mudroom and space for Daisy. You have a space here to hang things like a leash or coats. And then on this side, we'll have cabinets so you can have even more storage. Pull out water, food bowl, and a hidden bed. Places for her, so it's not just a mudroom.
That would be really nice. Space for Daisy, she needs a one.
She does.
So we're gonna start demo today at Marissa's house, and the kitchen is the big thing.
Everything's going, except the countertops.
I mean, we're not gonna use them in here.
Marissa wants to keep the countertops in case she uses them for a project.
Are we even guaranteed that these are gonna not break when we? No, we're not, because they're
thin.
So
they are thin, yeah.
Okay, we're experiencing the last moments of this cabinet's life. The midriff, for those who don't want to see the faces of the people they're talking to, just the middle.
I like a midriff. I look good and showing my midriff. This is my best part.
Let's do this. And it's not going to be a super quick demo, I really don't think.
We are on the wrong sides.
This is like it.
We are. We are in a bind.
What's happening?
I had the wrong hand under it. There you go.
Just slide it.
Good idea.
Yeah, okay. Good
That's
idea.
That's what I'm here for.
I cleared a spot right down the stairs to the left.
This is looking good.
Oh, yeah.
Bringing in a Dutch door.
It's going to be great for Daisy, so she feels like she can be a part of things. But
Daisy?
She also has, yeah, you know, Marissa has a dog, Daisy, and this is her room.
Daisy Dutch. That's what
she
called
the door.
That is the
Daisy Dutch.
This door is the Daisy Dutch.
Here's her bed chamber. We're going to put a dog bed in there. And then all of the storage, little mud room, like hall tree, locker area. And then we have those vintage lockers.
That they're going to go here?
Yeah. I mean, the room is almost finished. We still need cabinet doors.
You want to go in?
Yeah, I'll go in.
Now we got the Dutch door. We're ready to install it. And then this room becomes Daisy's room.
Daisy's domicile. Marissa will come in from work, and Daisy will be so excited. And then this is her little, like, kitchen countertop here. She can hop up and say, what's up? Where you been? Delightful Daisy Dutch door.
Delightful Daisy double Dutch door.
Marissa's house is so friendly and warm and like modern country, and I like it.
She loves her vinyl.
She's got a pretty good collection.
Oh yeah, my goodness.
I hope we made it strong enough.
Okay. It's so pretty.
Thanks.
How many boards does she have?
She has a lot. She really wants to be the hostess with the mostest. This house is totally set up for that.
That's
her perch.
Where she's like welcoming.
Marissa's job is what brought her to Laurel. And I hope that this house is what makes her want to stay here in Laurel. I hope that she's going to have so many great memories here. So many friendships are going to really blossom in this house.
Welcome to the Landon House.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my gosh. It looks so good. Oh, my gosh. That
new front door.
It's the best thing.
It is so welcoming. The door was hidden previously, and it's not hidden now. And it says, welcome in.
Oh,
I
love it.
Oh,
wow.
It's so cute.
It is so cute. It's so different. Oh,
yeah.
My gosh. I love this color so much.
It's your same paneling. We just painted it in a new light fixture. A new front door makes the whole room feel brighter.
It does. Oh,
wow.
My goodness. This looks so good. This is so practical.
Yeah. And Daisy has a home for while you're at work.
Look at that.
Look at the little plaque.
Oh, my goodness. That is so cute. I love that. I love that I can sit down and put my shoes on and leave her for the day.
See you later.
Dutch door.
That's perfect.
Yep, the cutest dog gate. Show them the other super hidden secret special.
I love extra special hidden secrets.
What is that cabinet door there?
This one? That's perfect. Mm-hmm. Perfect for her dog food.
See what that drawer is down there?
That is perfect.
Everybody loves a custom secret compartment, don't they? She's going to show it off to everybody that walks in that room. She's going to be like, look at this.
You have all the storage for everything. Daisy, your charcuterie.
No way. This is not charcuterie.
Sorry.
This is strictly Daisy.
With your house, we wanted to really focus on personalizing it with built-ins. So you'll see more of that.
I love that.
Mm-hmm. Let's keep going.
All right, let's go.
Okay, here is your house portrait. But I added Lucy because she had to be there, obviously.
She looks
That's
so
really
good.
Cute.
But look at this.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my goodness. This looks so different and so great, though. It is so open, and there's plenty of space for everybody.
Yeah.
Love that.
I don't even feel like I'm in the same house, though.
No, not at all.
It was so dark. It was closed off with the wall that hangs in your face, and then
the midriff.
So much storage.
It's super bright and clean and fresh. The perfect place for entertaining.
I love the uppers white and the lowers color.
Yeah.
Love that.
Look at all of this custom built in. Here's your oven and your microwave oven.
I am excited
really
to
nice.
Bake.